Hello, everyone, and welcome. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here. If you are a first-time visitor, thank you so much for checking it out. If you're returning, thank you as well. Today, I'm walking you through the updated version of Adobe Express Beta. Full transparency, everything that you see today might still be updated in the future, so just keep that in mind as you are watching this video. Also, everything that you see, you can also access this. I will share with you a little bit later how you can sign up for the free beta version of Adobe Express. Also, this video may be a little bit longer, but I will section it off in chapters so you can skip to your favorite parts. And with that said, let's go ahead and dive right in. Here we are at the new homepage of Adobe Express. It is new.express.adobe.com. This is where you will land. This is everything you want to see to get started with projects. You see right here all the different types of projects: TikTok video, Instagram stories, logos, etc. What do you want to make? And then you scroll through, you see text to image and text effects, the generative AI projects that you can start off here, quick actions and so on. I'm going to actually start off with the menu on the left-hand side. So again, home will bring you back to this. Your stuff is your projects, your files, your brands, your library. This is where you will see everything that you create. Now, remember, this is beta, so right now you don't see your projects from the old Adobe Express. You can click right here to access those projects. So just bear in mind, that's what you'll see here. This will be organized as projects. You can create folders. You can see what's yours shared with you recently, and then you can view these in different sorting methods, created names, modified dates, reverse order, and then you can see these files as a list. So this is your stuff, your brands, again, as I mentioned, and then libraries. These are my libraries that I have in Creative Cloud. So all the projects that I create, or actually content that I create in my Creative Cloud, I can access here. So that is what your stuff is. Let me now go to explore. Here is where you can explore the different types of projects. So think of these as templates. So the first option here, you have templates. You can start off with Instagram posts, stories, reels, and so on. Choose all these different ones and start from those projects. Now, right now, I'm just going to show you. I'm not going to start one actually right now at the moment. And so what I want to do is actually click through here and show you here at the top. You see the templates here. It's kind of the same thing what you see right here at the moment. If I click on photos, you'll see the Adobe stock photos that you can access, videos. These are video assets that are available within Adobe Express, which is awesome. This is like one of the features that I am super excited about Adobe Express, which I will work on in another video. But for now, again, I'm just showing you that. We have design assets, which we had in the previous version of Adobe Express, and frames, overlays, textures, etc., and then background. So everything you can explore here. Check out the explore menu. Now let's head down to the schedule. Now this is similar to what's currently available in Adobe Express. You can schedule content on your different social media platforms. You can see right here, I have some that I had already published in Twitter and LinkedIn. Now that was in my old Adobe Express account, but I can see those right here. If I want to create a new post, I can do that. I'll walk through this fully in a separate video as well. So again, I'm just showing you an overview of what's available here. And then the learn section here, these are different types of, I would say, blogs that you can look at to learn how to do different things in Adobe Express. Emerging logo trends of 2023, social media, and these are really great to learn a lot about how to build your brand and so on, design, marketing, etc. So for those of you who are entrepreneurs or side hustlers, you might want to check this out at some point. So really quick, I know I went over that, but again, this is the menu on the left hand side, and I clicked on home and it brought me back into the home page. Now I do want to point out this blue plus sign. I previously it was kind of purpley, now it's a blue button. I'm going to go ahead and click here, and now you see suggested sizes of types of projects that you can create. So if I scroll through here, these are a ton of different ones. So if you have something in mind, you can type it in here. So if I say, let me see, post, and I'll see all the different types of post types of sizes that I can start on. I can upload media here as well and begin a project. Quick actions, we'll click here. Now, if you used Adobe Express previously, there was a quick actions menu. It is here. One of the things that I'm super excited about that was brought into Quick Actions was this right here, Animate from Audio, which lives separately. Now it's in here. That is awesome. If you haven't checked that out, you might want to play with it. Again, a lot of these I will do videos in the future, but I want to, again, just give you a full overview of what's available in the new Adobe Express. And then we have custom size here, where you can create a project from a custom size. You can choose pixels, inches, centimeters, and millimeters, and then create that new project. So again, that is from the plus sign right here on the top left corner of your menu options. Now let's go ahead and move on to another menu section, which is the top menu bar, which is this black bar here at the top. There's a whole lot of new up there, and is really, I want to point that out and show you what's there. I clicked on this earlier when I was in the explore section, so I'm going to go ahead and just point this out. Here you can search everything that's available, not just in your files, but available within Adobe Stock and so on. So it will search all of these files, templates, photos, libraries, brands, videos, backgrounds, and design assets, similar to what you saw in, I believe it was in the explore section. So let's go ahead and click back here. And let's just say, for example, here I'm going to type in Adobe, and right now it's searching all. So it's going to search everything. So I have 10,000 plus results, and you can see I have a file, which is an Adobe demo video that I worked on a couple months ago when I was exploring this new Adobe Express. And then we have templates, photos, and videos. So I'll scroll down so you can see these are templates that have to do with file names that are labeled Adobe, and then there's some photos of Adobe tagged photos, and then there's videos. This looks like a Premiere type of B-roll here, and then there's some other ones here and so on. So you can scroll through right here. I can create from this video. This is really cool. Again, I mentioned the video portion, super excited about that. And what I'll go ahead and do is I'm going to go ahead and close that out. So you can explore, as I mentioned, everything. Right now you're seeing everything from templates, photos, videos, and so on with nothing in the search option. If I click here and narrow that search in my projects, I'm going to go ahead and just type in Adobe once again. And now you will only see folders that I have labeled here from Adobe Draw and Sketch, and then my file. So again, that is this first search option here at the top. And right now you're seeing my files, which I will go ahead and show all. And I should see everything come up here in a second if I hit enter, or not, maybe not. We'll see right here. We'll leave it as is. Oh, no wonder, because I'm in your stuff here. Let me go ahead and click on home. Continuing to the right, you can join the Discord group to give feedback. If you click there, you can join the Adobe Express beta. Right now there's currently about almost 1500 members here, and you can join and give feedback. Check that out if you want to give feedback as you go through using the new Adobe Express. Here you have, it looks like a science speaker there. There it is, the Discord. And then you can report bugs or problems with using Adobe Express. So you can drag images or screenshots of what's happening and add a subject description. Definitely use that. I've done it before as I was exploring Adobe Express beta. And then here you'll see notifications if someone adds you as a collaborator, which is a new feature. Before it was asynchronous, now it's synchronous. I'll do some more videos coming soon specifically about the collaboration feature. And right here, the waffles, when you click on there, you'll see all the different Adobe digital tools available. The little question mark icon will click here, and you'll see there's a welcome guide and what's new, get help, and there's community there. Check that out, explore that for help and anything else related to what's new with Adobe Express. This will take you to your Creative Cloud if you have a subscription to that, and then this is basically my profile. So that is the top menu. Let's go ahead now and move down to this first section here. What do you want to make? So in this section, you'll see there's recommended content, Instagram posts, flyers, logos, etc. You can scroll through and see all the different ones, and you can start from scratch or choose the templates that are available. I'm a huge video creator. That's like my favorite thing to do, is create videos. So for me, it's like the Reels and the TikTok video using those templates, which are amazing. Now you can get specific on the content that you want to create. So if I click on social media, everything that you see will be related to social media content, especially down here on the different templates. And if I choose video, you have all these different video formats that you can choose from. YouTube, I'm super excited about exploring this with YouTube. I currently use Premiere. This is also exciting to be able to do it all on the web. And then down here at the bottom, you can create videos such as animate from audio. You can create videos using your voice. And if I scroll down, there's all these different video templates that you can use. Huge. These are awesome templates there. And then you have stock video that you can use in your projects. Let's go ahead and click on photo up here. So you'll see everything related to photo, photo books, profile covers, YouTube profile photo postcards. And then here are quick actions. So text to image, text effects, anything related with photo, you'll see right here. And if I scroll down, I have the AI Firefly integration right here that I can use. I can create an image based on the text that I submit. If you haven't tried that, I definitely recommend that you try it out. And then we have popular photo templates here, and then your stock photos, and then text effects. So anything related to photos. So I really like the way that that's organized there. And then documents, so PDFs, flyers, menus, and then quick actions here, convert to PDF, and then popular types of documents that you can create, menus, resumes, brochures, etc. And then if you're getting into marketing your side hustle, here's things you can use: invitations, cards, generate QR codes, resizing images, and then got your logo makers right here, which is awesome. Then you got poster, business cards, card invitations. So very well organized. I do appreciate that. And then this, the generative AI that you can use to create content from scratch by adding text to images and text effects. I had created a video on Firefly. You can check it out. It was in beta, which this is also still in beta. So check that out if you want to learn more about Firefly. I'm going to head back over here to recommend it, because something here that really made me super excited is this right here. Start from your content. Now, if you saw me hover there, there's some little wording that pops up: photos, videos, or files. I don't know if you notice right here, there's PDF, PSD, and AI, which is Adobe Illustrator. So if you have content in any of those formats, you can bring them in and create. I'm gonna go ahead and just demo this for a quick second. I'm going to use the, let's see, I've got several here. I got PSD file, AI file, PDF. I'm gonna go ahead and start with this mountain bike riders. This is a logo I created some time ago. This is what it looks like. So it's converting the Adobe Illustrator file so that I might be able to use it in Adobe Express. And there it goes. We've saved your project and your files. Let's go ahead and take a little detour here really quick and just open this in the editor so you can see. There's my file. A little bit of editing that I'll need to do with the text here. This is a little bit off again, remembering that this is still beta, so there are some things that need to be worked out. The text here, as you can see, I've got it showing up, and this is cool. I'm really excited about this. And again, all of this is in different layers, just like I had them in Illustrator, and it's brought them in as different layers and so on. So definitely give that a try if you've used Adobe Illustrator. Now remember, always the caveat, this is in beta, so if something doesn't work right, make sure to give feedback to the project. I'm gonna go ahead and click on the home logo here to bring us back to where we were talking about this middle section of Adobe Express, the new Adobe Express. And so I'm gonna go ahead and click on the recommended to make sure I see the recommended content. And I think for now, that's kind of the overview of what's new. So I'm gonna go ahead and just start from scratch, one little demo project, and then we'll kind of exit out and finish up this video here. So as I mentioned, I'm really excited about video. I'm just gonna go ahead and just click the video here. And as you can see at the bottom, all these templates, I'm just gonna go ahead and let's go ahead and pick this one right here, Elijah Jones. So if I click that one, It's going to open up the project. You can see this timeline right here. And then you have, you know, Elijah Jones there popping through, the text there. So if I hit play, just going to go ahead and let that play through. So there's different, I would say, assets here. So we have this timeline showing the everything kind of together here. You have text scrolling through in and out. You have this animation rolling here. And then again, the video that was playing there. Now, if I scroll through, you see the different content that will show up. So if I want to, I can click and you see now all these different layers start to pop up and generate what's showing up. So right here we have Elijah Jones. So just for demonstration purposes, I'm going to go ahead and change this to Claudio Zavala. Let's do a little bit of fixing right here. Let's go ahead and click out until I move my name out. So we got Claudio. It looks like here we might have to make a little movement. There we go. I'm going to delete that and keep my name right here. There it is. So let's see what happens as I scroll through, hit play. There's Claudio shows up right there. And then my name goes away. Cool. Just wanted to show you a quick demo of working on a video here. I will have a more full in-depth video coming soon on how to create videos using the new Adobe Express. So now what I want to do is show you how you can sign up for the beta version of Adobe Express. So let's go ahead and do that right now. Here's a blog from a president from our digital business here at Adobe, David Wanwani. I highly recommend to check this out, read through it. I'll have it linked in the description below. A lot of great information here. And what I'm going to show you right here in the blog, there is a link, the latest version of Adobe Express. If you click that, it will open up. Now, I'm already logged in, but right here it says join the free beta. And this is, again, the new Adobe Express. And here you see join the free beta. To let you know, if you head on over to new.express.adobe.com, it will bring you to the page. It's free to sign up. You can use your Gmail to sign up. Now, if you are an educator, I highly recommend using your personal Gmail account for this. It is currently not available for EDU fully just yet, so stay tuned for that, but you can use it with your personal Gmail, so check that out. And that's a walkthrough of the updated version of Adobe Express Beta. Let me know what you think. If you have any comments or questions about this video or about Adobe Express Beta, please do drop it in the comment section below. Don't forget, hit that like button, subscribe, click the bell to be notified for future videos, and please do share this video with your friends. Thanks so much for stopping by and checking out this video, and as always, have fun creating and be good to one another. Peace.